Hello, hello! Hey there, Pack! How's it going? Just noticed I have some weird cable management today. So, hello! So, back with some more Zelda Oracle of Seasons. We're pretty close to the end at this point. Not a whole lot left to do for Seasons. So, hopefully we finish it with enough time to get going on Ages. Now that's going to be an interesting transition because we're going to need to do the password, and the passwords for these games were not exactly short or nice. You'll understand when we get to the password. But, yeah. we are still working on that community challenge. I'll go ahead and cheat it a little. Or not, because my computer is saying we're not live. Okay. Computer's being weird. Computer is being weirdo. That's okay. I will do it later. Alright, let's go ahead and switch on over to the game. So, last time, we ended with a little side quest. Should be trying to remember my buttons. Here we go. We ended a side quest that gave us this red ring, which is sword damage times 2. So this is a really nice ring to pick up. I didn't actually know... Well, I couldn't remember what the reward was for defeating all the golden beasts. But this is a really nice pickup, especially since we're doing a linked game. Because in our linked game, we will actually get all of our rings back. So when we start Ages, you know, we can be kind of badass with our level 1 sword in Ages, which will make... some of the early dungeons a little bit nicer. A few things. I was trying to figure out where the missing heart pieces were because we discovered that we've got... I thought I had them all and we're still missing 3. There's one that we haven't quite gotten to yet. And then the other two, I believe, unless I'm mistaken, one of them should be on Maple, and the other should be from Gasha Seeds. And I did want to kind of 100% this to a point. So we need to go plant some Gasha Seeds in weird places. Actually, I think one of the places we're going to have to go to... there's one in Sunken City that's not awful to get back to. But it's still a little bit further out. We're gonna plant here. Because getting the heart piece is random from Gasha Seeds.
It's rain, dude!
Oh, hello! Hello, Six String! How's it going, my friend? I just got started, so hello! Hello, Raiders! Welcome in! How was your stream? Playing Pokemon Emerald? Wait, I thought you were playing Jackbox last I checked. Anyway, how did it go, Six String? Did you guys have fun today? Oh, thank you for the follow, Metal Owl. Thank you. I'm Raya, Futon Crusaders. On Thursdays, I stream pretty much whatever I want. Lately, it's been a lot of Zelda. On Tuesdays and Fridays, I stream with my husband, RG, and we play a variety of games, blind games mostly, but also some multiplayer games. So, thank you for stopping in, checking me out, and hanging out, hopefully. And today we're working on, hopefully, the conclusion of Oracle of Seasons. We have a dungeon left in the boss, and then we'll be jumping into Ages, though that transition may take us a little bit because we are going to be doing a linked game. So we will have to fiddle around with a fun password midway through today. Which is always fun. So, yeah. Hello. Right now I'm planting a bunch of seeds because one of my goals was to kind of pseudo 100% this when we played, because there's not actually as much in these games as other games. I don't know why I'm trying to kill those guys, I just was. And we're missing 3 heart containers, one of which is attached to those seeds. I wonder where else I should plant. So you know what, there's a weird one up here. The certain locations are more likely to give you what you want. Usually it's ones that are a little bit more annoying to get to. So while it's nice to plant those seeds wherever you feel like it, that's, you know, convenient. Unfortunately, to get the heart piece, to have a better chance of spawning, you need to be a little more creative sometimes. So, there is one that hangs out over here. It's actually down there. I remember it being a decent one to plant for this, if I remember things correctly. This game is on. These games are honestly my number one request for Nintendo to, you know, res and bring to the Switch. Just because I love them a lot. I think they're a lot of fun. They're not super difficult games, but they're very nice games. I think they have a lot for when they came out, because these were originally Game Boy Color games. Though they were released towards the end of the Game Boy Color cycle, because you can't actually. They had special stuff if you played them on a Game Boy Advance. Not much of a special stuff, there's a shop. Which I've been meaning to shop at, but we don't actually have the money. So, best item in the game, the Rock's Cape. It allows us to get over here. Rock's Cape is just awesome. Because we got our red ring earlier, Lionels are like nothing anymore. Most enemies are pretty much mincemeat now for us. We're pretty strong. To make the boss interesting, I might unequip the ring. So this is actually our route to our last dungeon. As you can see, we could try to go through there. Could also come over here. So, we have a warp to Subrogia that we have not seen yet. Hey, AK! How you doing today? Welcome in. Yeah, we have a warp to Subrogia there we're gonna need to go take. Because why would they make the last one nice and not make us do some weird stuff to get to? What I need to get over there. I think I don't want winter, but maybe I did. I'm doing okay, just trying to remember a few things. I don't always remember things perfectly. I'm old. I did want winter. Didn't I want winter? I think we actually wanted fall. Looking at that. There we go. Yeah. Holes fill up with leaves in the fall. I've always been old. Yeah, that's RG's excuse. He's always been old. Not much we could do there, but it's fine. So now we need it to be winter because we can't actually get over to that warp. But in winter we can because the snow piles up. I woke up this morning with my hip hurting. I was really feeling my age. And actually, I was just realizing that a week from today is my birthday, and I'm not sure if I want to celebrate it on stream because I'm feeling old. So, welcome back to Subrosia. You guys, I think we walked past this site once or twice earlier. But we couldn't get to it because there's this stone in the way. Ugh, stupid stone. But we have to come up here for this room anyway. So this guy, I don't know what you want to call him, but look at this stuff he throws into this spot. Dungeon map, a flute, a sword. We could have used that sword, you know. Like, this guy is just, like, burning everything. Doesn't matter what it is. Bananas, boss keys, I mean, I don't know where this guy's getting all of his loot, but... And anyway, he likes to throw things. He calls it, this shoots off huge fireworks. Well, we don't have anything, we don't have any of those cool items to throw, but we do have a bomb. So, enjoy. That explosion refaces the map on the other side. And he's all happy because we made a giant explosion. Fortunately, we can't do it again. That's a one-time thing. Oops, I actually need that. Yet, you're 7 years younger than me, AK. I'm barely feeling my age. I think that stays open, yeah. We didn't do much exploring of Subrosia over here. There's actually a locked door. So... mostly because... we need those seeds and whatnot to grow. We also need to find Maple at some point again, and get her to drop on her piece. Oh, that one didn't work. So, I explained last stream why Rock's Cape is so freaking broken. It's for stuff like this. If you could have Rock's Cape at the very beginning of the game... oh wait, that's not the way we want to go. Like, you could navigate all of Subrosia pretty much. So we're gonna go grab Rosa and unlock that door. It's probably just a ring or a gacha seed. But right now we can actually use the gacha seeds since we're still looking for that heart piece. It's always nice when you can have an excuse to keep Pegasus seeds out. So, just a gacha seed. Like I said, not exactly unneeded. Check this one. We did, okay. That one we did do. When you go in a week in between plays, sometimes you don't always remember what everything you did was. Right. I think we've done everything we can here. At least for the moment. I mean, we still could go break 100 signs. What do you guys think? Should we piss off the Subrosian that loves signs? I don't know why I'm wrong. Oh, wait, there is one spot I probably didn't check. I have a... The spot that's just right here, and there's a door here. Then she runs off. I think this was just a spot that just, like, gives you free, I think there's just ore around here. Okay, there was nothing there. I actually don't remember. Oh, I actually do remember what's there. Never mind. I believe we will see that when we do the linked game. Actually. So we will be going back to Subrosia eventually, just not quite this moment, because we want Maple. We're still looking for the heart piece drop from Maple. Which is not right here. Let's sit it. Maple comes after we've killed a decent amount of enemies. Still kind of feel like we might have already gotten that one, but then I can't seem to remember which heart piece we might be missing then. So I'm a little stumped at the moment if there's one we missed elsewhere. So for the moment, we're going to assume it's that one. To get her to show up, we murder things. Because murdering's fun. But we are gonna start back now towards the dungeon, just... But the murdering also helps with our Gasha seed plants, so... Let me do a quick check over here. This one's ready to be picked. That one was useless. The one in the village is... not gonna probably give us a heart piece, so we're not gonna replant. This one up here has given me one from time to time, but... Ooh, money! Use that. Also, not super likely. I'm gonna go ahead and summon Dimitri. And we're gonna go plant somewhere else, and then we're gonna head to where we wanna go. And say hi to Dimitri. I'm gonna say it's up here, the one I want. There, here it is. Since this one's not on a major path, it's one of those that, you know, is a little more hidden. I just remembered, I don't think I did this. Over here. I should go ahead and do that. There's actually two things over here. I believe one of them is a ring. Don't remember which ring it is, necessarily. So we need to go here as Summer and as Fall. Because why not? We gotta do cleanup anyway, so... might as well get it done early. Or at least start some of it, especially when we're in the area. So what we'll do is we'll do one of them now. And then we'll do the other one later. If we feel like it. Because I don't want to swim all the way back here to do them both. And so we're just going to do Summer at the present. Dimitri go. They took Dimitri from me. Fine, we'll walk it back. It's all good. It's all good. The nice thing about this part of the map is we're actually already close to that dungeon 8 again. So we didn't lose all that much walking back and doing some of this stuff. okay. He was one of the nice guys. Some of these guys take your money. This guy was like, no, here, take some money. Okay, so I showed you guys entering that area from the other direction, but it can also be entered from this direction. This direction is just maybe a tad more dangerous, maybe, but it puts you right here already, so... You guys can be the judge if you think it's more or less dangerous. But now there's lava everywhere since we made the mountain explode. We now need to make it summer. For this. Okay, I think I was supposed to like fly over. No, it wasn't. That thing was just in our way. That's... Thanks, creatures. Thanks for bouncing into my way. Up the stairs. Okay. Everything is down with this. Push straight and kill a piece. Okay, now we're up here. I think I missed the heart piece, though. Wanted to check down there really quick, and the keys weren't gonna let me. Stop falling down holes, Link! Okay, there's nothing down there. Now, there is a heart piece over there in this area that we'll have to come back to. That'll be part of our cleanup after the dungeon at this point. So we took another warp, which brought us back to Subrosia. And it's because our final dungeon is in Subrosia. So here is level 8 Sword and Shield. Nice thing is, we can break pots now, we don't have to pick them up. We can't get to that guy yet, as you can see, this stuff doesn't move. Always re-equip my rocks cape habit. I just love the look of the rocks cape, too, in addition to its practical uses. Whee! Ow. I need to kill him. He hurt me. He hurt me bad. So we can't do anything in this room yet. Jump being great and still greatest ability in Zelda. Don't remember if we actually have to kill this guy. Honestly. But we're going to. Because he's pissing me off now. Dude, you should have just, you know, not pissed me off. Now I gotta kill you. Okay, we did. It was kind of an important item. Oh, pfft, I locked myself into the corner. Okay, we're good. Now, if I feel like it, I could pull out my boomerang and get some free fairies here. Which, you know, why not? I mean, if the fairy agrees, jerk. How dare that fairy just wander off like that? So, big giant hole, can't go do- well, there is actually a way to get across if you're a speedrunner. I am not, so we're just gonna take the old way around bit. Grabby grab there. Obviously, never travel in that room when you don't have health. Ouch. Or apparently this one. Flaming keys. They will set me on fire. Okay, I thought there was a button I pushed. So this is, I believe, our dungeon map in here. Or a compass. I don't think this is. Ugh! What this is damn ice physics! Okay, Link. Yes, I know it won't open from that side. I was trying to open it from the front! There we go. Compass! Yeesh! No hearts. just gonna see what's this way first. I think this is just a jump off, isn't it? Yes. Okay. So yeah, we wanna magnetize ourselves across. And hope we find a few hearts here. Can't actually do anything over here, so that was a waste of time. Because we don't have a key. That room, actually, I believe is our mid-boss already for this dungeon. But we need a key first. Okay, fine. You just stay away. Just stay away, Keys. Okay, I think I have to do this as soon as I walk in. There it goes. So yeah, that thing was just, you have to hold perfectly still for a few seconds, and that guy will move out of your way. I think it's the only time you ever see that mechanic used, too. So I'm sure you can see what we gotta do here. Oh, we dropped it. It happens. And there's our little pathway. We saw that room earlier. I apologize for anyone that gets bothered by beeping. I do not mean to be half dead. There we go. These guys can't be killed. So, we need them to stay away from us. They jinxed us, we can't use our sword. Like the other things that are just like, hey, we could use our sword to murder this thing. Nope. So here's our hyper slingshot. It is our dungeon item for this level. It's hyper. Just kidding. So we came up here earlier. Of course, I didn't fully know what I needed to do over here when I did, but we are gonna go grab that chest because if you see the turn thingy majiggy is facing so we can grab it, which is that key we were looking for before. Go back up, go this way, we go that way, we do stuff. We're making our way through this dungeon. It's all good, people. Thank you. break some more pots again. So now that we have the hyper slingshot, we can actually hit this. Because we hit all the eyes at once. Come here, you. You're bothering me. So we'll blow up some stuff and get this chest. This is another key for us. We like keys. Keys mean progression. Keys mean we're doing something right. What we don't like is our having only 3 hearts at this point. So I'm gonna have to play smart. I cannot spill life and remember what mini boss is here. Which one are you? Oh, you're that dick. Oh, crap. Okay. If I needed a different. So this guy changes color. When you shoot him. I don't remember if he changes color otherwise. Okay, I think I have to hit him. I have to be time. Okay. Just making sure. Oh. Oh no, he does switch on his own. So it's just going to be a lot of switching back and forth here on our slingshot. While trying to stay alive. Oh man, I do not remember how many hits this guy takes, but apparently it's a lot. Oh no, 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 no. No hitties. Okay, why aren't you dead yet? Like, seriously. I do not remember it taking this many hits, but maybe it did. Either that or I'm forgetting something about how you fight this thing. Oh, nope, there we go. There we go! GG, everybody! Mini boss is down. Mini boss is down! I was getting scared there for a while that I was forgetting something. Now, we are going to take a quick side trip with this warp here. No, I never came up here. I wonder if this was my dungeon now. We actually want to go down there to that spot. No, I think I actually wanted to be up top for some reason. Eh. That's what I thought. Dang it, I was trying to fly and I pushed buttons wrong. Got us a ring for our troubles by going back. So now we're gonna go back here. Whoops! Double right whammy into the warp. Of course, naturally, there has to be some keys causing us some problems. Well, thank you for the follow, Professor Shikashi. Cool name. Okay. Okay. I don't remember how to do this. We have to get all of these blocks of ice over there. Say it's. I'm gonna say you do this. Push this one down. No, wait, that's not right. I don't think that was right. Dang it! Try to remember. Memory! Come on! Okay. Because this guy is down. Okay, I think I see it now. If we do this, we push this guy up, which allows him to be pushed this way. That puts him there. They started something wrong. I thought I had it, and now I'm looking at it and going, nope, not quite, not quite. Okay, okay, okay. Who loves block puzzles? Now I think I have it, possibly. That was a weird pause. So then we do this. One. Two. Three. Haha! I can figure out push block puzzles. But can I jump? Dang it, I fell. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, shoot. I think I'm going too quickly on that dismount. There we go. Okay. Now we jump on top of these guys. They don't care. They think they get me, but I'm above them. Okay, we're good. We got the bridge unlocked. Like with most things, I don't technically have to kill everything, but it's fun to kill everything. So honestly, this boomerang may be like the second best thing in the game, because of how often you need it still. For, like, with stuff like that. I broke the wrong pot. So we need to push a pot. I think we need to do that door first. I don't think it matters if we go through this other one yet. That was the game just screwing with us. Eh, we got a heart out of it. We didn't take any damage. We're okay. Okay, now we need some booms. Good old explosions. Boss key? And now we go through this door. So the one thing we haven't found is our dungeon map, which I honestly cannot remember where it is now. It's probably somewhere at the beginning that I just kind of skipped over. It's probably in the room with these guys. But, you know what? We don't need no stinking dungeon map. We need to walk the path it did. And there's our key. And that path is random. So we're gonna need to grab this thing, this ice. Because the next part of this is we're gonna be chucking ice to freeze lava, because that makes total sense. Must be some really good ice. We can go down here, and we can actually grab this chest. Because we
we dodge the birds. So there's another key for us. Now, just to give you guys an idea, you can see where we can't access yet. Eventually, we're gonna make this whole floor turn to be walkable. I don't think I want to. I think we want to go back up the stairs we were at. Because the ice is in the other room. So, grab the ice again. And go to the next room. So you can see there's another spot for us to drop it. Then here's another spot. This one's locked by a key, that is fine, because we have two keys. So, there's another one down. I'm missing a key. I think it's part of this whole process. So now we go back again, because a lot of back and forth here in this section. The ice is only in this one spot, so we have to work our way back to it every time. So now we're gonna bring it back to that room, we're gonna change the cart's direction to do this one in the room we just passed. So, we're gonna drop the ice, change this, pick up the ice, and go back into that room. And now we have this part of the room frozen solid. It was nice of that guy to drop us a heart, wasn't it? One more time, back into that other room, but we're gonna go back down to the lower level. Because I need to find out if I missed a key somewhere. So this area is now covered. And I believe we want this staircase for that missing key. If I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, and I could have missed the key somewhere else. There it is. Nice thing about this, though, is let's pull out our boomerang. Get ourselves a free fairy. I probably should have grabbed the rupee, but that's okay. We got 600. Okay, so we now have all of our keys. We're gonna go grab the last thing of ice. And then it's gonna be boss fight time. So if you happen to be a subscriber to Futon Crusaders, feel free in just a minute or so to drop the boss fight emote into chat. Oh wait, apparently I forgot something. What did I forget here? I missed a step. I was all excited thinking I had this, but apparently I missed a step. And I think I know what I did. Down. over here. So remember, there was this that I decided not to mess around with. But I needed to prep that other room. I might have to go all the way back for the ice. I don't know if that'll stay in the room I dropped it in. It did not, so we actually have to backtrack all the way. Is my card in this room, though? Okay, that at least stayed. Okay. Okay, I was a little premature on the boss stuff, but, you know, Pack got ready for it. Pack's all ready. He's like, yeah, let's get some don't dies and boss fights in here. Okay. Okay, we got the ice. We now have our carts set up. And, by the way, guys, check out my rupee count. If you don't know where it is, it's right underneath the key icon. Okay, last bit of ice has been tossed. For those of you that like fun numbers, we got ourselves a 666. Could be an omen. Could be. Let's hope not. We have now officially dropped the last of our ice. It is now time for the boss. We gotta walk up here. And we walk up here. And we walk up here. And they, just because they were, I don't know what you want to call them. They decided to put an extra lock there. And here's our boss. This is a Medusa head. She will turn us into stone if we, with certain attacks. Like that. See? We're stone. We got stoned, everybody! Taking risks. Come on. Come on. GG, everybody. We got our heart container. You guys know what that means. Time for our final essence of nature. You got the changing seasons, an essence of nature. Scattered seeds sprout in spring, grow in summer, bear fruit in fall, and sleep through winter. It is an endless cycle of life, the changing seasons.
Futon, you already have the 8th essence? The changing seasons have filled me with my former power. I have something to give you now, and so come see me.
I think I've changed the tree's voice every single time I voiced him. So first, before we go back and do him, and, you know, talk to him, I mean, it's not going to matter exactly when we talk to him at this point. We have to talk to him before we can do the boss anyway. Whoops. I believe one of my missing heart pieces is in here. There it is. Like I said, we got 2 heart pieces left. I want to say they're on maple and gasha seeds, which makes them RNG dependent, and that of course is annoying. But at the same time, what we'll probably want to do is double check that that's where they are. she probably wanted to stay up there. Yeah, well, we'll take a long way back to that. If we can get the Gasha seed one, I will do a backtracking through all the heart pieces and make sure Maple's the other one. Simply because I just cannot remember. I thought we might have gotten hers already, but... courtesy of the game being like, you're missing two heart pieces, now I'm not sure. Okay, come on, Maple. If you have a heart piece, give it to us now so I don't have to worry about you later. Still no heart piece. Gasha seed, though. Ah, she took it from me. And all these ones are in trees, so she probably... did pick up a ring from her, though. Oh, I should actually keep my seed satchel out. So, first things first, let's go check those ones in Sunken City. So we planted here. So, Gasha seed sprout depending on the stuff you do. That's why it's usually, like, when you beat a dungeon, you've usually accomplished a part of it. This is like defeating a bunch of enemies and stuff. We'll grow them. So it's always pretty much safe to say after you finish a dungeon that your seeds will be ready. Same thing with Maple showing up after a dungeon. She shows up based on how many things you've killed. So, of course, if you kill a bunch of stuff in a dungeon, Maple's gonna show up. Only a fairy. That kinda sucked. Walks right in my path. He definitely has to die. Okay, the other one was over here. Oh, right, I forgot I can't do that. I'll pretend to be surprised, Pack.
It's a raid, dude!
Hello, hello! Welcome in, raiders! The house where Bumbo lives is here to say hello! Hello, hello! How'd the rest of your stream go, Bumbo? That shout-out going. Yeah, there's an origami dog too! Hey there, origami!
Look at this! It's a new super subscriber!
Oh, thank you for the 4 months, Bumbo! Huh. I was hoping I could just use my phone for shoutouts. It's being, it's not as nice. There we go, a shout out for Bumbo. And a shout out for Agami as well. Nope, I broke the shout out. The shout out always breaks. I'm too quick for the bot. There we go. Yes, well, welcome in, Raiders. Yes, we're playing some Oracle of Seasons. We just finished our 8th temple, or level, or we have, I guess they're technically levels in this game. So we're doing a little bit of cleanup. We're hoping to get our last 2 heart containers, but I think they might be RNG dependent, so we might move on without them and just call it good. But yeah, we're getting ready to finish this up. Yep, Dimitri's my boy. I love Dimitri. Oh, I need to go change it to ball really quick. I tried to forget that. Yep, Dimitri's my boy. I'll go ahead and call him in a sec. Just because it's fun. I need to change it to fall over here. Oh, he might show up top. Dang it, Dimitri! Why did you show up top? There we go. Got our boy Dimitri. I need to change it to fall now. Instead, doing a little bit of cleanup, I discovered there was a spot over here I never bothered to do earlier, so we're gonna go ahead and do it. We got some Ricky fans, we got some Moosh fans, we got some Dimitri fans. All the love for all the pet companions in this game. I love them all. You can't go wrong with any of them, really. They're all pretty well balanced. So we've got our Gasha Nut over here that still did not have the heart piece in it. So we are still missing the Gasha heart piece, or the Gasha seed heart piece, and this is why we might just call it. Am I out of seeds? I think I might actually be out of seeds. No, I have 3. Thank you! The game just didn't want me to plant, apparently. But yeah, if that's all we're missing is those, I'm not gonna worry too heavily about it. I'm not gonna make you guys sit while we try to play RNG with the game. Now, I still am kind of curious if the other one we missed was Maple or something else. Yes, the agriculture does not like me. Does not like me at all. I'll just ride Dimitri for a little bit. Because why not? Now let's see if I can do this. It's very easy to grab Dimitri sometimes on this spot. There we go. So we're gonna go to the ring guy. We're gonna get our rings appraised. We're gonna go grab the nut from the Maku tree. And then might as well just go take care of Onyx. But we do want all of our rings since those do transfer over to our linked game, any rings we pick up. I hadn't done these yet. These are special GBA rings. Whoops. You can only get them if you're playing on a GBA. I have the emulator. It took me a while to get the emulator set up for that, but I did eventually figure out how to trick the emulator into thinking we were playing on a GBA. Because honestly, we would be playing on GBA if I could. I don't think there's any more here yet. It's just all that stuff is all that's here. These rings, I don't believe, do anything. I think one of them is just, hey, you played on a GBA. Here's a ring for it. And I don't think the other one does anything special either. They're just kind of a completionist thing. We were never gonna go for 100% rings because, yeah, that would take a while. Oh, apparently we get the 1,000 monster ring. Oh, okay, chat. One question for chat, though, in regards to rings. There is one ring that we can only get in seasons and not ages. We need to go massacre 100 signs. Should we go taunt the Sabrosian that loves signs into giving us a ring? Two Zora rings. Not quite an encyclopedia, but I have spent quite a bit of time playing. So here, GBA Nature Ring. Life Advanced, that was what we got from the shop. We also got the Heart Ring level 2. Recover Lost Hearts, so I guess that one was pretty good, actually. And then Slayer's Ring, just because we got 1,000 beasts slain. Most of those actually didn't do anything for us. We will go ahead, though, and... take that ring, that heart recovery, just in case we need it at some point. So when I was talking about slaying, destroying a bunch of signs, sorry Dimitri, basically, you could just keep going back and forth on this sign, and keep murdering it. And then we can go back to Sabrosia and talk to the sign-loving Sabrosian, and he'll get mad at us because we murdered signs. And if you break 100 signs, that's what you gotta do. I think he has a sign outside his place too, actually, that you can destroy constantly too. When I think about it. Oh, we should also do one other thing. We should go visit our godchild for the last time in this game. Because once we beat Onyx, our godchild will be moving over to Ages. So we won't get to see him again in Seasons. But first...
Futon! You finally gathered all eight essences of nature. You've become a true hero who understands the essences of nature. You are hope for all that live. Take this seed.
You got a huge Maku seed. This should penetrate evil forces. Heh heh, freezing.
Futon, surely now you could defeat Onyx, the General of Darkness, and free Din, Oracle of Seasons.
Some hero! Oh wait, it's him.
Look,
I think talking.
At this.
Hey, Duck!
Super subscriber!
Thank you for the sub, Duck! And yes, he said penetrate!
Come if you dare, Futon! If you are their so-called hero, then their hero is no match for my powers of darkness! Gra-ha-ha-ha!
Okay, he's not saying anymore. Not doing too bad, not doing too bad at all. Break another sign. Sorry, Dimitri, you get to hang out right there. Onyx is a big wiener. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, last time visiting our kid. Our godchild. Look at him run! This is our godchild, Futon. Futon? I can't remember what we named him. Futon! I, Futon, am writing a song to praise Futon, the greatest hero. Woo-hoo! The kid loves us! See? Futon has grown! That is one hyperactive kid. Plus, considering we saw him, like, right after he was born and now he's running around, how long has it taken Link to do this journey? Hey, Futon, Futon grows by the day, and today I have more to teach. Finding spots to plant gacha seeds is hard. Dig holes, move rocks. There we go. We saw our godchild one last time. Like it's like Troy's kid from that episode of Next Gen. Oh my god, you're right. Okay, we're gonna go check on that sign. How many more signs we have to destroy. He is hanging out. Where are you hanging out again? Only if he's over this way. Which I was gonna destabilize the warp core. Yeah! No, he's probably just gonna aid Onyx in this case. He's the true final boss is your kid. Oh, nope, I guess he doesn't have a sign. The sign-loving Zabrosian doesn't have a sign outside his place. So this is who we're talking about. Simply divine, impeccably fine, gorgeous design, notably kind, signs! You've broken 19 signs! How could you be so cruel? So, yeah. Thank you for contributing, Pack! We're really close to that community game night now. Thank you for contributing as well, Origami! Now we're just gonna spend a couple minutes. Seriously, it doesn't take that long to destroy signs. Especially because we don't care about the sign droppage. We just want to destroy. If this bothers you, please look away. We don't want anyone getting sick by these scene transitions.